Let's start sitting. So I would like you to sit comfortably and we do just a few deep breaths. So make yourself a very comfortable sitting. Maybe sit cross-legged, like so, easy pose, or sit in pose of adapt with bare feet flat on the floor. Okay, or something different. Maybe if you want to stretch your legs to the front, that's also good. Okay, so let's make a little bit more space between the sitting bones, lengthening through the whole spine, taking shoulders back. Relax your shoulder blades, flat on your upper back, relax your neck, draw your chin slightly in to elongate the back of the neck and lengthen. Lengthen upwards, relax your hands somewhere on your thighs, close your eyes, and take a few deep breaths. Inhaling deep into the abdomen, middle chest, upper chest, and as you exhale, exaggerate. Draw your tummy muscles in, exhale fully, and so on. Few deep breaths, using the whole capacity of the lungs. Soften your tummy on the inhalation, and as you exhale, draw your tummy muscles in, exhale fully. The breath is deep and flowing. We use a deep breath to calm the mind, to calm the nervous system. Deep breath helps us to focus, and we bring more oxygen. That's very important, healing and anti-inflammatory oxygen into every cell of the body. Breath is deep and flowing. Take a moment and remind yourself about your intention. We all have intentions. Your intention can be very small or very big. Your intention can be just for this yoga class or for a day, for a few days ahead. And if you are in doubt, ask yourself how you can meet it to yourself. How you commit it to your health, and find the inspiration in your answer. And keep your breath deep, flowing, enjoyable through the rest of the practice. On your next inhale, open your eyes, relax your arms and your legs. And just stretch your legs to the front. Give your legs a little shake. Just relax, relax, relax your legs. Great. And then come on your all fours and we do cat and a cow stretch. Okay. Let's start warm up the back, the shoulders, the hips, the back of the pelvis. So you're looking at your hands. Spread your fingers wide. Creases on your wrists parallel to the front of your mat. Knees under the hips. Toes under. Inhale, you look up, and as you exhale, round, tailbone between the sitting bones, tummy in, inhale, abdomen down, lift your heart, look upwards, exhale, and round, inhale, soften between the shoulder blades, lift your heart, look up, exhale, and round, and continue a few times. Of this lovely gentle stretch. Work with your breath. Inhale, you look up. Exhale, and you round. Let's do once more. Inhale, look up. Exhale, and round. And then bring your back parallel to the floor in neutral position. Make more space between your feet. Or between your knees and your hands, and then come up to down facing dog. Squeeze your arms, squeeze your shoulders, lift your hips, stretch, and then start a spot walk to stretch the back of the legs. So we start to warm up the hamstrings, the back of the calves. Let's have a good stretch and remind yourself that you don't need to do everything. So, and if it's too much, you can always back off. And just to try to enjoy your practice, enjoying the movements. We want to feel good in our body.
Great. Another deep breath. And then come up high on your tiptoes, look between your hands, bend your knees and walk towards your hands, into your forward bend. Make space between your feet. Hips width apart or take your feet wider. And take one hand at the back of the pelvis, just checking which way the back of the pelvis, tipping forward or back. If the pelvis tipping back, so benching is more forward, then tip the pelvis forward. This is much nicer for the lower back. Squeeze the legs, squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Strong, steady legs. Take your hands to the hips. Lift your elbows, lift your shoulders, lift your chin. And come up standing with a straight back. Squeezing the legs, squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. And then exhale and relax your arms and just roll your shoulders, just soften, 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 loosen up. Great. We go again into the forward bend. We're going to do extra shoulder stretch now. So watch me for a second. This is demonstration. We're going to go into this shape. Chest over your thighs. We're going to squeeze the shoulders, lifting the arms. We're going to stay for 5 breaths. Inhale, you're going to lengthen. And as you exhale, squeeze the legs, engage your tummy muscles and bow. Maybe you can straighten the legs, maybe not, it doesn't matter. So just make sure that your lower back is happy when you straighten your legs. And when you come up, bend your knees forward, lower your arms, back is straight, and then come up. Okay, so let's start. Check your feet parallel, hips width apart. Interlace your fingers behind, inhale, lengthen, bend your knees and fold. Okay, relax your neck, nod your head, squeeze your shoulders, lift your arms. Now inhale, lift your chin and stretch away from the hips. As you exhale, squeeze the legs, tummy in and fold, lift your arms a little higher. Lovely stretch. And again, inhale, stretch forward, squeeze the legs, squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Exhale, tummy engaged and bow. Lovely. Another 3 rounds like so. Nice and easy. Exhale, squeeze, squeeze, squeeze your legs and bow deeper. Lift your arms a little higher. Twice more. Listening to your body. Lots of energy on the legs. Squeeze the legs towards the midline. Last round. Inhale. Exhale, squeeze, squeeze, squeeze your legs and bow with your strong, steady legs. Just take a moment here, relax your neck. Bring your arms down, bend your knees a little forward to ease your lower back and your hamstrings. Lift your shoulders, lift your chin, come up with a straight back. Tummy muscles lifting as you come up. Squeeze your tummy muscles in. And then relax your arms and roll your shoulders, soften, 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 loosen up. And then just stretch your arms upwards, interlace your fingers, invert your hands. And then just stretch sides of the body, nice and easy. Lovely stretch. That's it. Squeeze the legs, press your feet into the floor and stretch. Away from the hips and you stretch in downwards and upwards simultaneously in both directions. From the hips downwards and upwards. Lovely. And then come back. Come back to the middle, relax your arms, and just roll your shoulders, soften. Well done. Come to the front of your mat. We do sequence salutation to the sun, and we're going to add lots of different stretches into that sequence to stretch and bring more energy to the rest of the body. So you are in the front of your mat, and make space between your feet, hips width apart, or a little wider if you feel very tight in your hips or the lower back. Just take your feet wider. Bring your hands to your heart. Inhale. Lift your sternum, exhale, relax your arms, inhale, gentle back bend or just stretching upwards. And as you exhale, forward bend, bend your knees if you need. Touch the floor or your shins, inhale, on your finger pads and stretch forward. Exhale, squeeze the legs and bow. We do it again, inhale, lengthen forward, either holding your legs or the floor. Exhale, bow a little deeper. We do it again, inhale, stretch. Away from the hips. Exhale, bow over your strong, steady legs. Now move your hands by the side of your heels and step back with your right foot back. High leg lunge. Take a deep breath. And then bring your back knee down to the floor. Squeeze the legs, hands to your front knee. Lengthening the tailbone. Strong tummy muscles and stretch your arms upwards. Deep breath. If your knee very sensitive, so you have a couple of options, either placing blanket under your knees or think about moving more energy on your foot behind. So strong that foot behind, so this knee,
the back knee is very light on the floor. So bring more energy on your toes. Press your toes into the floor. Deep breath in. Exhale, touch the floor. We're going to change side. Step back to down facing dog. Deep breath.
And then come up on your tiptoes, right leg up, look between your hands, that's where you're going to step. Step forward, help with your hand if you need.
And then bring your back knee, left knee down to the floor, squeeze the legs, inhale and come up. Lengthening the tailbone, turning muscles in, stretch upwards, move more energy on your foot behind, press your toes into the floor, press, press, press. So strong that this left knee is very light on the floor. Deep breath in, exhale, touch the floor. Step back to down facing dog, deep breath. Lift your hips high, thigh bones moving back, heels down. Have a good stretch for the whole back of the body. And then thinking about plank or half plank. Let's choose option. Plank with straight legs, if you feel this is too much for today. Knees down for the half plank, and that's okay. Squeeze your arms, squeeze your shoulders. Take a moment here, strong core muscles, deep breath in. And as you exhale, lean forward, knees to elbows or bend your elbows. Lie down, point your toes back, slide your hands forward for the sphinx pose. Elbows beneath your shoulders, press your whole legs into the floor. Lengthen the tailbone until you feel your tummy muscles start to lift on the floor. If you get that lift, it's so great, because you know that your muscles start to engage to support your lower back. And then see if you can lengthen more forward. Then soften between your shoulder blades. Squeeze your shoulders at the back. Keep that energy. One hand by the side of your chest, shoulder back. Another hand. And then come up to raised cobra. It doesn't matter how far. Maybe just halfway for the first round. Then soften your buttocks, shoulders lower. Do double chin, maybe lift your chin a little. Inhale. And as you exhale, drop your hands back and stretch forward away from the hips. Lengthen, lengthen, lengthen. Toes under, down facing dog, or come on your all fours. And then down facing dog, deep breath. And if you want to sport walk, feel free sport walk. Bend your right knee, then the left. Deep breath. And on your next inhale, come up on your tiptoes, look between your hands, right leg up, and see if you can step forward. Big step forward, helping with your hand is good if you need it. Take a deep breath in, and then bring your back knee down to the floor, squeeze the legs. Padding for sensitive knee, if you're knee sensitive, we go into the twist. So what I want you to do again, thinking about lengthening the tailbone, squeezing your tummy muscles up, right arm, look up or just look to the side, and if you can straighten your back leg, go for it. Straighten your left leg, lift your chest, move back of the head to the heel behind you. Deep breath, lovely twist. Keep lengthening the tailbone to lengthen through your whole spine. Inhale, and as we exhale, look down, touch the floor. You're going to step back to down facing dog. Deep breath. And then change inside. On your tiptoes, look between your hands, left leg up, step forward, big step forward, back where you started. Take a moment here. Maybe bring your back knee down to the floor, lengthen the tailbone, and look up or look to the side, to the left side. Maybe you can straighten your back leg, go for it, squeeze the hips, lengthen the tailbone and lengthen through your whole spine. Keep this length. And deep breath. Inhale. Exhale, look down, touch the floor. Down facing dog. Step back, take a deep breath. Sport walk again, and just check how you feel. You probably start to feel that more energy flowing now. You might feel a little bit warmer. And this is a good thing. On your next inhale, come up on your tiptoes, look between your hands, bend your knees, walk towards your hands, into your forward bend. And then look at your feet, bring your feet together, bend your knees. We're going to come up to the chair pose. Really squeeze the legs, squeeze your feet and your knees. And then come up halfway with your arms in front. Let's check. How are you feeling this posture? You want to move your hips a little bit more back. If you see your knees, if you look at your knees, you can see your feet in front. This is good. Tummy muscles lifted. Arms moving into your shoulder joints. And maybe you can stretch your arms over the head. Maybe not. Don't worry about everything. Maybe you just want to place your arms parallel to the floor. And this is good. Strong core muscles. Strong legs. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze your legs. Tummy muscles lifted. Inhale. And as you exhale, fold over your thighs. Relax your neck. Roll your shoulders, just soften, 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 relax. We're going to do once more, if it's appropriate. Squeeze the legs, bend your knees, hips back. It doesn't matter how low you go into this posture. Listen to your body. Stretch your arms. Again, little bit of tailbone. Lots of tummy muscles. Squeeze and lift. And maybe stretch your arms over the head. Strong legs, strong core muscles, strong shoulders. How's your breath? Deep and flowing breathing. Inhale. Exhale, fold. And relax your neck. Again, roll your shoulders, relax, relax your shoulders. Well done. Now move your feet wider, hips width apart. Okay, hands by the side of your heels. Step back with your left foot back. Take a deep breath. And we're going to come up to warrior one pose. So looking at your left foot, you want to hop to the left just a little bit more. You definitely want to see space between your feet, hips width apart. And then maybe start with your back foot flat on the floor. Come up with your hands on your front knee and thinking about your lower back. Lengthening the tailbone, lifting your tummy muscles, stretch your arms, take a deep breath. And then bring your hands together at the back of your head. Lift your chin and lean back. So you want to also think about your armpits moving back and then lift your chin. Deep breath. And if this feels very easy, you want a little bit more effort, thinking about your back heel. Can you lift your back heel off the floor? Is that okay for you? Do this posture in a high leg lunge? Maybe yes. Maybe no, that's okay. Just adjust your practice. Deep breath into your chest. Expand your chest. Stretch your intercostal muscles. And then inhale. Stretch your arms. Look somewhere straight ahead. And we're going to stretch forward. Stretch forward. Lengthen, lengthen, lengthen. Touch the floor. Step back to down facing dog. Deep breath. And we change. When you're ready, on your tiptoes, look between your hands. Left leg up. And step forward. Big step forward. Back where you started. Again, you want to have that space between your feet, hips width apart. Maybe start with your right foot flat, hands to your front knee, lengthening the tailbone, tummy lifted, and stretch. Warrior one, hands together, and take your hands behind your head, lift your chin, lean back, gentle back bend. Maybe lift your back heel off the floor, if that's okay. And breathe, expanding your chest, with deep inhalation, lift your sternum, back leg, super strong. Can you check that back leg? Press your toes into the floor. Well done. Inhale, stretch your arms and then lengthen forward. Lengthen, lengthen, lengthen. Place your hands down, down facing dog. Let's have a good stretch. And again, if you want to sport walk, feel free. Or maybe you want to bend your knees, lengthen through your spine first, and then straighten the legs and keeping the length through the back. Now thinking about plank or half plank, choose your option. Plank or half plank, again, listening to your body, squeeze your arms, lift your tummy muscles up. We're going to do a little challenge for the core muscles. Lift one hand over the floor, then another hand, and I want you to squeeze your shoulders at the back, squeeze, squeeze, tummy lifted. Listening to your body. Remember, you don't have to do everything. We just have a little challenge here. Be playful. Well done. Another round on each side. And when you're ready, lean forward. Knees, elbows, or just bend your elbows. Lie down, point your toes back, come up to raised cobra slow, no rush. Lengthening the tailbone and slowly peel your chest off the floor, shoulders lower, doing double chin, keeping back of the neck long, and then lift your chin. Inhale, and as you exhale, with the shoulder blades, carry your heart forward, stretch, 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 forward, shoulders lifted, toes under, down facing dog, deep breath. And I want you to look at your hands. Let's check how's your hands doing. Spread your fingers wide and press more energy, or press all finger pads into the floor stronger. Press, press, press. And then stretch back. Armpits slightly lifted. So that will help you to lift the arm bones, so you're not going to stand on your wrist joints. So we're trying to create a little bit of lightness between the wrists and yoga mat. On your next inhale, on your tiptoes, look between your hands, left leg up, and step forward. Big step forward, helping with your hand is good. Looking at your right foot, hop behind your left, and come up standing into the warrior two pose. Inhale, big circle, and you're looking over the left. Let's check front knee above your front ankle, hips moving back. We want to see back hip in line with your knee and your back ankle. And if you can sit lower, go for it. Just sit lower in ideal posture. We want to see front thigh parallel towards the floor, but don't worry. If it's not happening today, squeeze the legs, engage your core muscles and breathe. Breathe in deeply into your chest. Inhale, can you lengthen through the sides and then stretch? Stretch, stretch, left elbow to your knee, right arm over the head, look to the side or look up. Lovely side stretch. And I want you to check your back foot. Can you press your foot into the floor? And can you feel the outer edge of the foot on the floor in this stretch? Maybe you can touch the floor with your left hand and stretch a little bit deeper. Breathe. Another deep breath. Inhale. Exhale, engage your core muscles, then touch the floor. And step back to down facing dog before changing side. Lengthen through the whole back of the body, hips still lifting high, and your thigh bones moving back. Change inside, inhale on your tiptoes, look between your hands, right leg, step forward. Left foot hopping behind your right, squeeze the legs, and come up. Inhale, big circle with your left arm, looking over the right, checking again alignment, front knee, hips moving back, do you need more space? Take your feet a little wider and sit lower, if it's okay. Don't worry to do everything. Another deep breath, we'll lengthen through the sides and stretch, 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 right elbow to your knee, left arm over the head, and maybe this is just enough. Or take your right hand at the back of your right heel and stretch a little bit more. And let's check again the back foot. Press the outer edge of the left foot into the floor stronger. Press, 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 and stretch. Deep breath. Inhale. And as you exhale, look down, touch the floor. Step back, down facing dog. Take a deep breath there. On your next inhale, on your tiptoes, look between your hands, left leg up, and step forward, big step forward. Look straight ahead, take a deep breath, and as you exhale, lift your tummy muscles up and step into your forward bend. Forward bend, make space between your feet, hips width apart or wider. Just listening to your lower back, and again, one hand at the back of the pelvis. Do you need to bend your knees more to tip the pelvis forward? That's absolutely fine. Bend your knees more. Hold your elbows. We're going to stay here for a little while. Squeeze the legs. Maybe you can stretch from one side to another side. But don't worry to do everything. You can just stay here. Maybe holding the floor or holding your legs.
Work with your breath. On the inhale, you stretch. On the exhale, squeeze the legs and bow deeper. The movements can be very tiny, and don't worry, this is all good. Just don't work over pain. Bend your knees more if you need. Breathe deeply. And we're going to come up now. Take your hands to the hips. Bend your knees just a little bit more forward. Lift your elbows and your shoulders. Lift your chin, come up. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze the legs. And then stretch your arms upwards. Salute into the sun. Exhale. Hands to your heart. Take a deep breath. And then relax your arms. Relax your legs. Okay, well done. Good job. Take a drink. Okay, I definitely need a sip of water. Great. The tree pose. Tree pose is the balance pose. So if you feel your balance is a bit tricky today, come to the wall and you just can bring one finger on the wall. And when you are in your tree pose, when you're in your variation, try to challenge yourself, try to let go of the wall. Okay, so let's try together. And you place your foot where you feel, okay, this is just right. Maybe this option, heel on inner leg and your toes on the floor. Or maybe you can bring your foot beneath your knee or above your knee. And I know some of you love like a little bit more advanced options, like a half lotus. Half lotus looks like that when you place your foot across your thigh. And then you stretch your arms. So if this is you, so try to be comfortable with your knee and your hip when you do this. Okay, let's do it together. So right foot, somewhere where you feel very comfortable. Maybe just the heel on the inner leg, or your foot beneath your knee, or above your knee, avoiding the knee joint, or the half lotus if you like it. So I'm going to try today this half lotus. Okay, I'm going to squeeze my hips, lengthen the tailbone, tummy muscles very strong, and look straight ahead. Looking at that point, and notice your breath. Slow down your breath, calm, steady breath. Inhale and stretch your arms. Open your shoulders, stretch your arms and stretch your fingers, and breathe. We stay here for 3-4 deep breaths. Don't make yourself very tired, so just listen to your body. And if you need to stop anytime, you don't have to wait for my instructions. Breath is easy and flowing. Just challenging the balance, improving the balance, improving the stamina. How's your core muscles? Can you squeeze your tummy muscles in? Calm breath. And then bring your hands together. Draw your hands to your heart and then relax. Okay, relax, shake your legs, relax, relax, relax. Okay, and we change directions, let's change legs. Okay, again, look at that point straight ahead. Choose your option, maybe just the heel on the inner leg or your foot beneath your knee, above your knee, or the half lotus if you feel this is appropriate. And we're going to squeeze the hips, lengthening the tailbone, tummy muscles engaged. And when you feel okay, this is feel steady, you stretch your arms, stretch your fingers like a branches on the treetop, and breathe. Thinking about qualities of the tree. Staying steady, strong in any weather, in any life situation. Steady, strong, grounded, with calm breath. Finding the balance. And then bring your hands together. Draw your hands to your heart. Relax your legs. And give them a little shake again. Relax, relax, relax. Okay, well done. And now we're going to squat and sit on the floor. If it's appropriate for you to squat with your feet wide, and then we're going to take knees wide apart. And if you feel this is not good for your knees, I suggest do again the chair pose. The chair pose looks like that. So with your feet
parallel and your knees facing the same direction as your second toes. So, and maybe you can stretch your arms over the head as well. So on the sideways it looks like that. So you don't have to take your knees wide. So the knees like so, or your arms like so. Okay, so if you're happy to go into the squat with me, please do. Take your feet wider and then maybe even lift your toes up first. That gives you more support for your knees. Inhale. And as you exhale, going lower. Okay, maybe stop on the halfway and just check how you feel there. Like, can you go a little lower? Maybe even lower. And maybe you can bring your hands together and with your knees, take your, with your hands, or not the hands, this is elbows, with your elbows, take your knees a little wider apart. And just take a moment there. Stop there for a moment. Engage all your core muscles, your pelvic floor muscles lifting, tummy muscles drawing in and up. So draw the energy upwards. And take a moment. Strong legs, strong hips, strong core muscles. Take a deep breath. And then you're going to sit. Do you need to hold the floor? Hold the floor and then sit on the floor and then stretch your legs in front and give your legs a little shake. Relax, relax, relax. Okay, well done. And please be seated comfortably. Watch me. I'll quickly show you these options for your baby cradle pose. And I use baby cradle pose as a warm-up before going into the pigeon stretch. So options. So option one, rocking the baby leg. Option two, rocking the baby leg. Or option three, foot into the crease of your arm, hug your knee, and then rock the leg. So, and I know sometimes it's too much to ask from the hips. So what would be good for you now to sit on yoga block or yoga or blanket. Just fold the blanket and sit on it. So bring yourself a little bit higher with your hips. Okay, I'm going to be your mirror. So we're going to do it together. So let's do it together. So you bring your right foot in, okay, if that's okay with your knee, or you can have your leg straight and then look at your left foot, flex your foot. So your toes active and your toes join closer to your shin. So we want to create this energy, loop of the energy. When your toes join closer to your shin, the shin muscles got engaged. This is good for the knee. Grab your heel and hold your knee. So maybe this is enough. Or go under your shin bone. Can you go under your shin bone? Maybe you can place this flexed foot into the crease of your left arm. So sorry, that's your right. And then interlace your fingers and rock the baby leg. So remember, you can come back to the previous option, to the easier option. Okay, how's your back doing? Are you sitting straight? Squeeze your tummy muscles in. Support your back with your core muscles. Have a good stretch here. You have lovely stretch for all the hip, all muscles around your hip joint, around the thigh. Okay, and please don't work over pain. If it's too much for your knee, go to previous option. And that's okay. Just gently, gently stretching and preparing for the next posture. This is a lovely stretch. And if you feel you don't want to rock, you can just sit here. You can just sit and enjoy the stretch like so. Okay, and let's stop for a moment. Now lift your foot a little higher. Squeeze the leg a little closer to your chest. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. And how's your core muscles again? Engage your tummy muscles. Lovely, and then change. Stretch your legs, give your legs a little shake. Relax, relax, relax. And then we change. So I'm your mirror, take your left foot in. Look at your right. Flex your foot again, spread your toes, draw your toes closer to your shin. Create that loop of the energy there. And hold your heel and your knee. Maybe this is just you. Or arms under your shin bone. Maybe this is you, or your foot into the crease of your arm, and then interlace your fingers. Okay, let's rock this baby leg, nice and easy. Don't worry to go into the full options, full advanced options. Okay, just listen into your body. We want to have a good stretch. Okay, and again, checking your core muscles, draw the energy upwards. Trying to keep the back straight. I know it's difficult to keep the back straight in this posture. We just try. We just try to sit straight. Okay, well done. And then stop for a moment. Lift your foot a little higher, squeeze your leg. Just stop here. Enjoy the stretch. I know it's quite a strong stretch. Lots going on around the hip. Deep breath. Strong tummy muscles. Squeeze tummy muscles in. And then relax. Relax your legs. Give your legs a little shake. Yeah, relax, relax, relax. Well done. And bring your feet together. Your feet together. Four corners of the feet pressing against each other. You hold your shins above your ankle joints. Inhale and lengthen. And as you exhale, if there's a space for you to fold forward, go for it. Fold forward, and then you take your elbows wider, closer to your knees, and press your elbows into your inner legs and legs up into your elbows. So create good resistance here. And again, look at your feet and check. Your toes active, just stretch your toes. Squeeze the four corners of the feet against each other. And let's lengthen forward a little bit more. Stretch, stretch, stretch. Keep resistance between your arms and your legs. Arms pressing into your legs and legs up into your arms. Have that good resistance. Lovely stretch. And we're stretching forward, lengthening forward, lengthen, lengthen, lengthen. Your tummy muscles up, lift, lift, lift. Well done, come back now. Great, relax your legs, shake your legs, shake, 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 relax. And we do the half boat pose, short rounds, knees together, feet together. Now you need to sit on the floor. If you were on the block, just move the block to the side. Sit on the floor. Inhale, lengthen, shoulders back, relax your neck, lean back, find your balance. Can you lift your both heels off the floor? If not, just lift one heel down, stretch one leg, and maybe you can add arms. One arm, if you do one leg, do the opposite arm, and then change. One leg, one arm, or maybe you're here with two legs, maybe you're just trying to do one arm, another arm, or two arms. Stop here for a moment. Breathe deeply into your chest. Squeeze the legs, squeeze your feet, and push your feet away from the hips. Inhale. And as you exhale, relax. Okay. Lean back. Keep the pelvis forward. And just shake your legs. Relax, relax, relax. Okay, well done, everyone. So we're going to do another two rounds, short rounds. Don't make yourself very tired. Okay, second round. Feet together, squeeze. Spread your toes, knees. Squeeze. Inhale and lengthen. Shoulders back, relax your neck. Engage all your core muscles. Lift all the energy upwards. Lean back, find your balance. One leg or two. Choose your option. And then push your feet forward. Maybe you can straighten your legs completely, maybe not. Keeping your knees bent is absolutely fine, especially if you have tight hamstrings. This is good. And maybe add one arm and another arm. And if you feel very steady, maybe you can go lower for the full board pose, but don't worry if this doesn't work for you. Just stand halfway, deep breath, and then come back. And release, hold your legs, relax. Lean back, keep the pelvis forward, shake your legs, relax, relax, relax. Okay, we're going to do another round. Keep breathing deeply. We need lots of oxygen to all working muscles. If you want to work a little bit more, with more effort, grab the block or the brick and squeeze between your inner thighs. This is if you want to work with more effort. Don't worry to do everything. So, and again, find your balance. Inhale, lengthen, shoulders back, relax your neck. Squeeze the block or squeeze your legs, find your balance, and push your feet forward. Okay, squeeze, squeeze the legs, squeezing the legs towards the midline. And again, maybe add one arm, another arm, or just keep holding the legs. It's also good. Just keep squeezing the legs, squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. If your lower back is clear, go lower for the full board pose. Remember, you don't have to do everything. Really squeeze the legs and then come up. Deep breath and then support your legs. Relax. Well done, everyone. Move the block to the side. Okay, lie down on your back with your knees bent. You take your arms out, away from your body. Tip the pelvis forward. Restore this little space between the lower back and your yoga mat. And you're going to take a few deep breaths. Close your eyes. Bring your attention inwards. And just relax. Relax into your breath. Slow down your breath. Relax your abdomen. Relax your breath. Nice and comforting breath. Inhaling into your tummy, soften your tummy. And as you exhale, squeeze your belly button in. And again, inhaling into your abdomen, soften. And as you exhale, squeeze your tummy muscles in. Exhale fully. And let's do one small exhale again. Inhale into your tummy and soften. Exhale, squeeze your belly button in. Exhale fully. Well done. And then roll over to your side. Come up, sitting, and then come on your all fours. We're going to finish with the lovely pigeon stretch. And the pigeon stretch is great to create more space for the lower back, for the hips, for the back of the pelvis. Nice and relaxing for the lower back. So let's start on all fours. Come on your all fours. Okay. And we're going to do right leg first. So looking at your right hand. Actually, I'm going to go around like so. Okay, so you can see me better. Okay, sliding the right knee to your right hand. And looking at your foot. Move your foot just in front of your left knee. Okay, now take your back knee back with ease if you have this little space. And now if this is appropriate, maybe take this foot and move your foot a little bit more forward like you did in a baby cradle pose, and you draw your toes closer to your shin. Okay, don't worry. If this is not appropriate for your knee, if it's too much for your knee, just skip this posture. Don't worry. Or come back to the previous option with your foot flat and your toes pointed somewhere to the side. So whatever is suitable for you. Again, we're going to take a deep breath here. And we're going to do the cow stretch. Lifting your tailbone and lifting the chest. And now, like in the cat stretch, tailbone between the sitting bones, tummy in. And see if you have space for the back knee to move back again. Go lower with your hips. And then go on your elbows. Take a moment here. Maybe this is just enough. You can stop here and breathe. Squeeze the hips. Well done. And again, doing little cow stretch. Chest lifted, tailbone lifted. Exhale, tailbone between the sitting bones, tummy again engaged. Check again space for the back knee to move back. And then stretch your arms forward. Okay, stretch your arms forward. Maybe even bring your hands together in prayer position and just stretch there. Forehead is on the floor. Deep breathing. And again, let's check the hips. Squeeze the hips. Squeeze in the hips. Tummy muscles lifted. Your tailbone lengthening towards that back heel. Your core muscles engaged, lifting upwards and supporting the lower back, the hips, back of the pelvis. Listening to your body. And how's that back leg doing? Back leg is active, not on holiday. That back leg drawing towards the midline. Have a good stretch, steady stretch. Another deep breath. And then slowly come back. Lift your head, hands to your front knee. We're going to push back to down facing dog. Deep breath in. Step back and spot walk a few times. Bend your right knee, then the left. Let's do this a few times. To loosen up the hips, to loosen up the legs, and just check which leg feels longer. I know that one leg feels definitely longer than another. And then come back on your all fours. You're going to change side. So left knee now, left knee, draw into your left hand and your foot moving to the right, just in front of your right knee. And then take your back knee back now. And if you can, move your foot forward, flex your foot, keep your toes active. and check again with your front knee. Is that okay for your front knee to do this movement? If not, just maybe just skip the posture or do cut in the cow stretch instead. Okay, doing the cow stretch. And then like in the cat stretch, tailbone, tummy muscles lifted. Let's check space again for your back knee to move back. And then elbows down on the floor. Take a moment here. Soften between your shoulder blades. And again, thinking about the cow stretch, the movement is very subtle. And like in the cat stretch, tailbone, tummy muscles lifted. Checking again space to move back a little bit more. And then maybe even straighten your arms. Okay, straighten your arms to the front. Okay, or stay on your elbows or bring your hands together in prayer position and stretch forward. Easy breathing. And how's your hips doing? Can you squeeze the hips? Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Lift your tummy muscles. Nice and easy breath. Strong legs. How's that back leg again? Just draw that back leg towards the midline, your foot, your shin. Draw it in. Another deep breath. And when you finish, lift your head, slide your hands to your front knee. And we're going to step back to down facing dog. Step back, sport walk. Okay, breathe. Breathe with ease and enjoy the stretch. And again, check in which leg feels longer, or maybe you're now balanced. Okay, so finding that energy flow through the legs, through the hips, through the lower back. Check in with yourself how you feel now. And then come up on your tiptoes, knees wide, sit into the child pose. Take your hips back, closer to your heels, and relax for a few breaths. On your next inhale, lift your head, slide your hands to your knees. Okay, well done everyone. And now lay down and relax into your shavasana. Okay, lay down, take your feet wider than the hips, arms away from your body, palms facing upwards, and just relax there. And if you need to put your socks on, jumpers on, or cover yourself with a blanket, please do. Relax and soften. And I will be sitting for you and read you a little poem. Okay, make yourself comfortable. Lie down, relax. Okay. Make sure that you're warm so you can relax with ease. And when you're lying in your shavasana, let's check all the alignment, how you feel in your body, your feet wider than the hips. And you press your hips into the floor, restore the lumbar space. There is a space between the lower back and your yoga mat. And then completely relax your legs. And then check your shoulders, shoulder blades flat on the floor, arms away from your body, palms facing upwards. Back of the head, nicely balanced on the floor. And if you're not sure, you roll your head from shoulder to shoulder, just soften, relax all neck muscles, and then come back to the middle. Smile to relax your facial muscles. Leave the beginning of the smile on your face. Softly close your eyes and relax. Let go of all the unnecessary tension. Notice your breath. Inhale for count of five. And as you exhale for count of 10. And again, inhale for count of five. Exhale for count of 10 and soften. With each exhale, soften and relax into the steady support beneath you. And as you relax in, I'm going to read you a poem from another yoga teacher, from Dana Fold. And the poem called Who You Are. Who you are is so much more than what you do. The essence shining through the heart, soul and center. The bare and bold truth of you does not lie in your to-do list. You are not just the surface of your skin, not just the impulse to arrange the muscles of your face into a smile or a frown, not just boundless energy or bone-bearing fatigue. Delve deeper. You are divinity, the vast and open sky of spirit. It's the light of God, the ember at your core, the passion and the presence, the timeless, deathless essence of you that reaches out and touches me. Who you are transcends fear and turns suffering into liberation. Who you are is love. Relax and enjoy your breath. Now, as your short relaxation comes to the end, bring your awareness back to your surroundings, back to the room you are in, to your friends, to your family, to your pets next to you, and deepen your breath. Extend your inhalations, exhalations, wiggle your toes, your fingers, slide your legs together, arms by the side of your body. Inhale and stretch. Take your arms over your head and stretch away from the waistline. Stretch, stretch, stretch. And when you feel sufficiently stretched, hug your knees. Rock from side to side. And then roll over to your right hand side and slowly come up to the sitting. Then sit comfortably for a moment with your hands in Anjali Mudra, in front of your heart. Close your eyes. Inhale, lift and lengthen, and then slightly lean back to feel strong support of your back muscles. Support steadiness of the universe. Reflect your practice. Reflect your intention of the practice. Notice how you feel. Enjoy extra strength, flexibility, and clarity of mind. Traditionally, we finish class with one gentle om. Exhale first. Inhale. Om. Bow your head to your heart, to the light within you, and open your eyes. Well done, everyone. Thank you very much. Namaste. And have a lovely day.